Kobe practice today?
He came out and got some shots up. Then ice down. You know, he'll get ready to come out and do a little bit more tomorrow to get ready for Friday.
You think he will play Friday for sure?
I think so. He's telling me something different.
No,
you know, right now,
plenty of time off.
You know, he felt pretty good today. He came out and got some shots up, like I said. We'll amp it up a little bit tomorrow and then get ready for Friday.
So he's not shooting the most accurate, obviously, but you feel like the offense is more settled when he is out there?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, he knows the offense extremely well, so he can tell guys where they need to be and how to get to it. And we'll run a lot of it through him and through Roy because Roy's such a good passer in that low post. You know, but yeah, I mean, it's a lot more subtle. I mean, it was obvious to me watching the Detroit game and then watching us against Phoenix that when he was out there, the offense was it ran more smoothly than it had been against Phoenix. And I mean, we got to get used to that because he's going to be in some games and some games he's not, and we still have to be able to run the offense, you know, according to who's in the game. You know, so we didn't do a good job of that against Phoenix.
In games, are you still seeing D'Angelo struggle a little bit with the actual creating part of the offense? A lot of times it seems like he's coming up the floor, dishing it off to somebody rather than creating something.
Well, I think right now he's still trying to find his way, which is you know, okay, you know, for a young player. You know, he's trying to find his niche and trying to find out, you know, what he can do within the offense to be successful. And as I've told him, I'm not looking for you to average 20 points a game. I'm looking for you to be our facilitator and get everybody where they needs to be, but also to be aggressive when you have the opportunity to be aggressive. So he's trying to, I think, figure out that happy medium, you know, and it's hard at times, you know, but he's going to keep learning, you know, he's going to keep going through it, and he's going to make some mistakes, and he's going to do some really good things, and it'll all come together, I think, pretty soon.
As a coach, how does the process work with really just building trust for a rookie and, you know, like extending that trust and just feeling comfortable with giving him more responsibility?
From a coaching standpoint?
Yeah.
Well, it's just like anything else. You got to earn it. It's just like players got to, you know, make me want to trust him, you know, and he's one of those guys that, you know, I'm getting to that point where I'm trusting him, but I still want him to continue to learn and not try to do things on the fly, you know, just try to stay within the system as much as possible. But, you know, I got a lot of faith in the young man, and I know it's a hard road, and I know it's going to take him some time to get it all. And as a point guard, the biggest thing and the hardest thing to overcome is the fact that you got to know where everybody is. It's just like a quarterback. You got to know where everybody is at all time, you know, through the offense. So he just doesn't have to learn his spot. He has to know everybody's spot, and that's tough.
Do you think he knows that trust you have in him is building, like from game one to now?
Well, I think he knows. We talked the other day about it, and I told him, you know, there's a difference in being aggressive and shooting and being aggressive and getting everybody involved, you know, and those are the little ins and outs of being a point guard in this league. So, you know, I try to use different illustrations of things that I've, you know, dealt with in the past to try to relate to him so he can get it. And again, you might hear it at that particular time, but it might be a week later before it hits you and you say, okay, now I know exactly what Coach is talking about.